How you doing, my beautiful people? We're back again on the channel Africa Unity platform. My name is King Edwis and I'm here to give you more insight on what is going on in Africa. You know, so today we'll be talking about Ghana and the prolific president of Ghana, Nana Akufo-Addo Dankwa. You know, it's been a great development from Twitter bringing their headquarters to Ghana, and now the German government are trying to partner to move on in partnership with the president of Ghana, you know, to bring more development to Ghana. And the Ghana president, Nana Akufo-Addo Dankwa, have did a great developmental innovation in Ghana. Like, it's a big time. Like, they're dealing, building good roads, you know, repairing schools, free education. It's been doing a lot, you know. And the Ghana government is welcoming great investors to Ghana, on the motherland of Ghana, you know. And and Germany itself, like one of the most prolific country in Europe, the German government have already come out to talk and to back up the establishment of the Ghana West African for Global Health and Pandemic Prevention in Ghana. So they're saying they're going to build, like, put the headquarter for the whole Africa, Ghana, for the whole Africa, for the establishment of Global Health and Pandemic Prevention. They're going to build the headquarter for the prevention of pandemic, and, you know, for global health prevention in Ghana. I know. So this review, this was revealed to the public by the ambassador for Ghana in the on Twitter, you know. So on his Twitter handle, you know. So everybody heard about this and people go wild again, like, oh, why is it only Ghana? Is it only Ghana? Let me tell you something, my people. On this platform, it's all about unity, it's not about division. When people are doing better, when people are doing good, other people will want to emulate them and do like them, you know. Look at the music scene, for example. You see the Nigerian people going wild and breaking boundaries, like breaking doors in the international music scene. So you see other African people to trying to gravitate to the sound, like people from Tanzania, you know, and people from Ghana, you know, and other people too, because they know that's where the money is. So they find peace in Ghana, and they know money will be there, because where there is peace, there is money. This is what we're saying to the Nigerian president, to the Nigerian people. This is the second time again. They have overlooked Nigeria to Ghana. I know it's all for the whole Africa, but these people are coming out and they're saying in bold, like, we want to come to Nigeria before, but now we're coming to Ghana. We're going to build the headquarter for the prevention of good health, for the prevention of pandemic, you know, and global health in West Africa, in Ghana. Which does a big stuff, because a lot of people are going to benefit from it. They're going to get good jobs, you know, the medical people, the medical personnel, people that works in the hospital over there. They're going to make, they get new developmental, new exposure, you know. And I know if there's nothing good in Ghana, people won't be going there. So I'm saying kudos to the president of Ghana, Nana Akufo-Addo Dankwa. Ever since he became the president of Ghana, so many good things have changed. The face of Ghana in the international community have changed, you know. This is what we're saying about good leader. He come out, addresses people, talked about everything going on. Even when they have the clash between the people in the market, he will come to the market in the sun. It's not like some president in Africa. So this is what we're saying on this platform. It's all about unity. It's not about division. It's all about unity. It's not about division. Just to show you and tell you what is going on in Africa, that this is what we have in Africa, in our motherland, on the rich soil of Africa. So I'll be coming to an end of the segment today. I'll be saying one Africa, one people, one unity. Because, my people, if we can't do it for ourselves, nobody will do it for us. So we need to stand together, support ourselves, be there for ourselves as an Africa, and for the betterment of the people in the international community. So my name is King Idris, and that's been a good one. And kudos to everybody that subscribed to my channel. The new subscribers, you're welcome to the family. It's all about unity out here. It's all about good news. It's all about development of African youth and African people for the future and for the betterment of Africa. So I'll be coming to an end on this segment today. I'll be saying one people, one Africa, one unity. Kudos to the Ghana government, you know. Kudos. Thank you.
I place great hope in their capacity to shape the future of Africa and make Africa the lion that it was meant to be. Africa has to have a strategy to reap the demographic dividend that that the youthful population offers. The Asian Tigers, so-called, South Korea, Japan, Singapore, and Malaysia, are where they are today because of the systematic investments they made in the development of their human capital. The period of boom and growth happened when their populations shifted from ones of many dependents to ones dominated by working age groups. And this is where Africa is today. We should not fail to realize that we are at the brink of a breakthrough. Having said that, I must obviously add that the population of opportunity will not automatically guarantee us a future of growth and prosperity. Demographic dividends do not come automatically. They have to be earned. To realize the dividend, African countries have to invest in the empowerment, education, and employment of our young people. With over 40% of its working population between the ages of 15 and 24, Africa is the youngest continent in the world. This represents a staggering amount of human capital. And according to the African Economic Outlook, this set number is set to double by 2045. Yet too many of them are trapped in poverty with few opportunities to learn or to earn a decent living. According to the World Bank, youth account for 60% of all African unemployed. For those that manage to find work, they do not do so in a place that pays a good wage, or develops their skills, or provides a measure of job security. The Brookings Institute states that more than 70% of the youth in the Republic of Congo, the Democratic Republic of Congo, Ethiopia, Ghana, Malawi, Mali, Rwanda, Senegal, and Uganda are either self-employed or contributing to family work. No one needs to tell us that mass employment in Africa, especially amongst her youth, is a ticking time bomb. The so-called Arab Spring showed clearly that lack of employment opportunities can undermine social cohesion and political stability. With between 10 to 12 million youths joining the labor market every year, Africa has to pay maximum attention to job creation. Ahmad Salkida, a Nigerian journalist who has had rare access to Boko Haram, the jihadist group operating in Nigeria, has said that although the sect is driven by ideology, pervasive unemployment in northern Nigeria makes predictably for easy recruitment of jobless young people. A World Bank survey in 2011 show that 40% of those who join rebel movements say they are motivated by a lack of jobs. Young people are willing to risk everything to improve their circumstances. We have seen in recent times high numbers of them taking harrowing risks around the Sahara Desert and the Mediterranean, trying to reach the mirage of a better life in Europe. What this means is that if we provide them the right environment in Africa, they'll make our continent great. If these youth are encouraged to spend their considerable energies at home, Africa could experience huge economic gains.